Nicole's Kitchen. I'm actually filming another episode because somebody asked me a very important question. Somebody came to me and said, hey, Paul, what do you do to make steak taste better? How do you make your meat taste better when you're trying to entertain people? Well, today I'm going to teach you how to marinate. So this is Chef Paul. Welcome to Paul's Kitchen. Hit like, subscribe, and share. Join me on our Facebook, join us on our YouTube, and join us on IRC. So, I got two really good pieces of steak here, which my wife has been belly aching for a couple of days for me to get make it, but I work and I don't have time. So I'm going to do it tonight. So first, we're going to take this steak, and why do you want to marinate, you ask? Like, what is it about marinating that makes things better? Well, give me a second here. And it's not dripping of blood, it's actually a lot of water. We've been defrosting it, and I defrost things in water. So, but anyways, why is marinating better? It helps tenderize things a little bit, it makes things a little bit nicer. It just overall, it gives things a little bit nicer flavor. So I've got this pan in here, so we're gonna set some steak in here. So first off, what do you do? Okay, so number one, cut a few holes in here just so things can get a chance to drip and go into it, and the steak has a chance to breathe it in, and that's important. This is my judgment hammer. And I'm just going to beat this a little bit. I'm not going to beat it a lot. It doesn't really need it. Now, mind you, when you're done with this and this finally goes in there, you need to wash your hands. It's very, very important. Everything has to. So, again, this on both sides, let's give it some nice little slits. And this is going to make it more tender, it's going to give it more flavor, it's going to be just a little bit better. Do you need to? No, but sometimes if you're entertaining, you want to make sure you're putting your best foot forward, you want to make sure that things are just the best. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to set these inside here for now. Now, if you're entertaining, you want to make sure that you're actually getting the best. You're getting the best choice of meat. You want to make sure that your meat is very is a good cut. You want a good thick steak. You want to make sure it's cut well. It's flavorful. You can get sauce for it. You can do whatever you want. I don't like putting a whole lot in. Mine's very. I don't want to say plain Jane, but it's not going to have a lot of everything on it. Why? You don't need it. Like, steak will taste good on its own, but you just need to make sure you're doing certain things. So, you're gonna salt it. And when I say salt it, steak, you should really salt it. It's gonna bring all the juiciness out when you start cooking, especially how we just put a whole bunch of slits in here. Now, this is not my normal thing. Sarah and I were just talking about this a bit ago. I usually prefer to get my own garlic and chop it itself, but Amy, for whatever reason, decided to get this. So, whatever, we're not going to waste it. I'm just going to put it in here, and I'm going to just mix up a little bit. Again, I'm going to put a little bit of apple cider vinegar. Don't need a whole lot, just a little splash. And believe me, it will go on both sides. I got some garlic powder. And trust me, marinating this, by the time we take this out and we start frying this up, it's going to taste so good, it's not even funny. And that's onion salt, by the way. Now, I really like my pepper. Now I got some Black Tower or white wine. Now I'm not going to pour a lot on this. And for those of you, Bill, who don't understand, this is the alcohol is going to boil out. You're not going to be getting drunk off eating steak. I'm just going to put a little bit on, not that much, don't need a lot. Alcohol is great to cook with because it does burn out. I'm just going to mix this around a little bit. And last of all, I've got a chopped onion. Just going to mix this up here a little bit. I'm going to cover this and I'm going to set this in the fridge for 4 hours. You might even want to put it in overnight if you want, 24 hours. The longer you put it in, the better it will taste. I would say 2 hours at the minimum, 24 most. But by the time you take this out of the fridge and you start frying that up, this is going to taste so amazing. It's going to be buttery. It's just going to just like, oh. You're going to notice a difference between doing this versus just taking it out of the package and start frying it. This would be better. So try that out. Hopefully you like it. Let me know what you think. Drop a comment. So anyways, guys, I hope you like. So please hit like, subscribe, share, tell your friends about it, and have a great day.